It's been about 10 years since I documented Thailand. The first time I went, I documented Rajadamnern. In 2019, I went back to Rajadamnern and I shot the stadium on film. I shot it on film because this was a vintage stadium and it needed to be treated in a vintage way. So I took my Pentax 6x7 and rolls of film. I walked into Rajadamnern and I wanted to show you Rajadamnern through my lens. I wanted to show you how different it was from America. There's only one locker room where people get oiled up and massaged. There are people with towels on their faces getting rubbed down with Thai liniment, and you could be laying down next to your opponent. There's no red corner or blue corner. Everyone's the same on old wooden benches getting rubbed down by their team. Tape is used on the knuckles, unlike the Westerners where they can't use any tape at all. And this is Pentax. He was the fighter I've been looking at and paying attention to the past few weeks, and he was the main event of the show. There were also Japanese fighters there fighting in the lower weight classes, I think 48 kilos. They were all IBF champions. One thing that I noticed that's universal is prayer before putting on the monko. No matter what race, religion you are, you have to fight for something bigger than yourself. Personal. It could be for your family, it could be for yourself. One thing's for sure, it's bigger than you. It was interesting to see the Japanese fighters here fighting in Rajadamnern. Before, there weren't really many foreigners that were fighting 10 years ago. And now there are a lot of foreigners sometimes. This kid was 18 years old with 30 professional fights and he just won his belt. He's a young kid from Japan. If you notice, there's not people hitting pads or they're barely shadow boxing. And that's how they warm up out in Rajadamnern. Usually the family's all there. There aren't really security guards or anything. People stay with their family, source of comfort. It's interesting to see all of the team there just gazing, looking at the fights. People were receptive to me. I was able to photograph anytime I wanted. In Thailand, you sit next to your opponent pretty much, either behind you or next to you, before your bout, and everyone's the same. Before Pentax walked out, I took his portrait. I think he came out pretty dope. This is his entire squad, the Jit Wanong Gym, all sitting next to him with his opponent behind him from PK Sunshine Gym. The same thing, people walk up, they pray before they go on, and they perform the white crew. A beautiful white groove. Some people think it's fancy, some people think it's really basic. It's beautiful how you put it. Fight in the main event is different than what you see in America. Not a lot of movement, but when the movement's there, it's explosive and precise. Not a lot of brawling. A lot of feints, and it's usually whoever gets the last exchange is the one winning. The team is separated by fences at Rajadamnern, so you all cheer together. The crowd yells with each and every strike. It's amazing to hear. it's a game of inches, really, to know your distance and how your opponent fights. High level Muay Thai is a beautiful thing to witness. I also realized how an elite Muay Thai fighter can carry a fight and make it interesting for the gamblers. How he can control the pace, how he can control the fight. Even when he's much better than his opponent. During the last round, there's already a decisive winner in Thailand, so they don't waste the last round to fight anymore. There's an understanding between the two fighters in camps and the judges and referees, and they understand who finally has won the match. They live again to fight another day. Shooting Rajadamnern is an amazing experience. Something I'll never forget.